Merry Christmas Eve, Eve, peeps. This is Tracy here, your friendly neighborhood paper pusher. I am here with December's paper pumpkin kit and a little sneak peek of January's. And I gotta tell you, paper pumpkin just keeps outdoing themselves. I knew that this kit might not be for everybody, but I am a pun lover. Oh, I love puns. They amuse me to no end. And this kit is just so cute. And if you want to cheer somebody up, I mean, a laugh's a good thing. So I can see that this is childlike or for the childlike, such as myself. It's such a great kit. So I've seen some pictures. I haven't actually opened this kit. I opened it just enough to see the stamp set because I can never wait. And I didn't get this in time for last Thursday's, but it came like late Friday. So I've had it all weekend, haven't looked at it, was waiting, and then the week just got busy. So then it got a lot easier to not look because, you know, who has the time? Well, here's what I'm going to show you. Okay, actually, you know what? I'm going to show you this first so I can move it out of my way. This is the next kit. So, and I'm going to tell you this. The reason I'm going to tell you this now is because if you would like the January kit, you have to either ask me to get you one or subscribe, and I'll put the links in the video post, by the 10th of January to get it. Because if you don't, there's really not a lot of chance of getting it after the fact. There are refills for the December kit, but the refills don't come with the stamp set, and the stamp set is too funny in this one to not have. So for this one, it's the same deal. Now, to be clear, this is the January kit. There's 10 cards in it. There's 5 each of 2 different patterns. They're all these kind of blushes and pale pinks and golds, and it's kind of hard to see in this picture, but it's a heart-shaped card inside of this envelope, and then the X's and O's are kind of the printed envelope. So they always go big on the envelopes, which means you can either put the card in a very fancy envelope, or you could repurpose the envelope and make cool things out of it too, because it's always nice. So this is the kit itself, which you have to subscribe by the 10th of January if you'd like. This is the add-on to the kit. So this is extra. It's 20 boxes, 20 tags, and 10 yards of this gold cording. And it is $13.75 plus shipping and tax. And I can't order those until the 25th of January, but I love them, and I can see giving those to many, many people. They're 1¾ inch by 1¾ inch. So Stampin' Up! Has a few little, or has had in the past, little gift boxes that are 2x2, and they fit just a nice amount of candy. Sometimes if the container's too big, you can break the bank trying to fill them with candy. And not everybody really needs that much candy. So these are just a nice little size. You'd be able to pop in a bunch of kisses or, you know, something, jelly beans. I'm a jelly bean fan. Or something like that into them. They're just the perfect size. So I can see making these up and passing them out. I think I mentioned before, Christmas always gets chaotic in the end, and I rarely have time to finish the Christmas cards plans that I have. So I do Valentine cards instead. And I do lots of Valentine treats. Just to people that I'm happy to know. So I will be definitely ordering these. So if you want some, let me know by the 25th of January. But if you want the cards to go with it, you have to let me know that a lot earlier. So I'm going to try to see if I can focus this, give you a better look at it. Okay, so that's the add-on. And because I did slightly peek at this, I'm going to show you that there is a little... Lots of times they put flyers in the paper pumpkin kits. So this one has a much clearer picture of the card. And here's what I can see. I can see a very cool envelope. I can see the card. I see a vellum heart, and I see pink. And I love vellum. Oh, and so this card is going to look awesome. And so, like I said, you get 10 of them, 5 each of 2 different patterns. Pretty sure those are the same patterns. I just couldn't get that one to print well. So, that's January's paper pumpkin kit. Decide by the 10th of January if you want it. But here's December's ever so punny kit. So, like before, ta-da! We have the Early Espresso, which is the nice dark brown color, stamp and spot. We have the reason to get the kit. Am I going to make this work? Not that way. It's worth a try. One of these times I'll figure it out. You know what else? Actually, I just realized because I flipped this over, which I didn't before. I was hoping it was white on the back, but it's not. But in the, it's fine. Because look at that. Though I'm going to take a picture of that because it's nice and summarized in there. This is all of the cost for the subscription for Paper Pumpkin, or if you want to like pre-buy stuff. In January starts celebration, which means for every $60 you spend, you get free product. And so they've even added on the bottom here how much. So if you buy like subscriptions, whether they're for yourself or as a gift, how many free products you can get with your thing. So isn't that awesome? But unfortunately, it's not white, which is what I was looking for to try to make it so you could see what the stamps say. Well, that's not quite working. So you can see there's some fruit on here, though. There's fruit, there's eggs. I'm gonna make it so you can see them. There's toast, and then there's a bunch of faces and a mustache and some glasses and a party hat and a little speech bubble. But there's, you are cherry sweet. I'm sorry, that's the pits. I pick you. Thanks a bunch. Peel better soon. Celebrate. Go bananas. Let's grow mold together. A toast to your success. That might be my favorite. Piece of bread, a toast to your success. You tell the best yolks. Have an excellent day. Excited for you. And maybe coming in second is, I loaf you. So those just amuse the heck out of me because I love puns. I have a cartoon somewhere in my, you know, box of treasures. A cartoon. Yes, a comic strip. That says, laugh and the world laughs with you. Pun and you sit alone. And I have that for I don't know how many years. That's probably a 30-year-old comic strip. But that's how far back it goes that I have loved puns. Once again, I should know better and take the noisy tissue paper out of the box that I'd never keep or do anything useful with. Okay. Oh my goodness, look at how cute. Okay, so, again, I told you, I've seen a few sneak peeks, but I didn't actually look this far at the kit, because it's so much more fun to do it with people. Let's see. Okay, these are such fun, happy-looking cards that, like I said, a little fun card in a and a joke to cheer someone up. Perfect. We got some little dots and then some little hearts. Look at that. That's for the I loaf you. Okay, so we'll put those off to the side. Oh, here, we'll do them this way so you can still see what all the good stuff that's in here. Seriously, though, the stamp set is awesome. So like I said, there are refills available. I checked. But the refills are only the consumables. So you don't get the ink spot. And you don't get the stamp set. You would get the embellishments and the adhesives, and you'd get all these delightful little pieces of paper that there seems to just keep being more and more of. That's a piece of cardboard. And you would get the instructions. Oh my goodness, they're so cute. Okay, so 9 cards, 3 of each, plus envelopes. And then, I don't know if I've mentioned it before, there's lots of resources for Paper Pumpkin. There's, Facebook pages and Pinterest pages. Some of them are Stampin' Up. Some of them are just fan clubs. Some of them are demonstrator-run pick fan clubs. Oodles and oodles of pictures and alternatives that you can find. But Stampin' Up also does... So right on the back of the instructions, there's like some alternates. If you want to do something different than this, here's some ideas. And you get a newsletter. So the newsletter came out either yesterday or the day before. I want to say the 22nd. Maybe it was yesterday. So on a regular basis, though, once a month, you will get a newsletter, and it has information about the kit, some alternatives, tells you how to make these extra things that they put on the back in the instructions, shows you some links to some other stuff, and if there's refills available and stuff like that. So as a subscriber, you actually would get that as well. So yeah, because some of these are cute. Look how cute this is. And I can assume, yes it is, because I can see there, that this is the envelope turned into a fabulous treat holder. That's just one of the cards. That's another envelope. Remember how I told you they go all out with the envelopes? Well, let me show you what I meant. So these envelopes, oops, I can't get them to face the right way. Ooh, look at that one. So this is, I don't know if the camera always represents, kind of beige with very cool earthy splotches. This is a nice little striped one. And this is polka dots. So this is what you can see in the example, right? This polka dot, they've opened this envelope out and used it as the piece in the back here. And with this envelope, they've scored it and folded it into a box, and then they've just folded this piece down to make the cool little front part. There's so many creative people out there with so many good ideas. So you can either make the kit exactly the way it says, or you can branch out and just do whatever you want. Lots of times too, you'll see demonstrators who will show you like only using what's in the kit. There's a lot you can recycle. And if you have other envelopes to use to send the card, it's great. But if you don't need envelopes to send the card, then yeah, why not make something out of these pretty envelopes? Here. I'm trying to get everything in the shot. We'll see if that's a good idea by the time I'm done. But yeah, you could just replace them with white ones or just not use envelopes. But yeah, the envelopes are always, they go all out. And then we have the cards. So again, the swatch. Very cool. I have to turn this over so I can see. So what is intended for the cards, I guess, is, yep, this one. So I love vellum. Vellum just has a cool thing. So this has this cool splotch look to it. And then when you pop out the vellum circle, I can see two vellum circles. Okay, that one's on the tip. This must be the smaller one. And you put a little vellum over top of it. It just kind of diffuses it a bit. It also gives you like just an extra layer. Right, so sometimes you need it for the very, very bright patterns or paper or stuff behind it, and other times it's just to give you like that extra layer to give you some extra dimension. So here's some little splotchy cards. There's lots of vellum. Ooh, one of these cards, oh, the one with the banana. I guess you can make it whichever one you want, but in this sample, it's the one with the banana. Has the Hello Arnie die cap for you. So isn't that cool? And then you have glue dots in your kit, but you also have dimensionals that you can just cut in half to make them skinny enough to go behind here. And you can mount up the word hello. This word always escapes me. It always takes me a minute to recall the right word that I want. Scallops. Little scallops to go here, which you can see in the, they've showed them in two of the different samples, are just going underneath the sentiment. And it just gives, that's the please focus noise that is crucial to the success. See, I stopped doing it. It stopped focusing. It just gives a little extra color underneath the sentiment. Makes the sentiment pop. So we have that. We have all the labels you need. We have a little green watercolor spot. We have some gingham. Very fun gingham. But see, this is what they're giving you. So they're giving you, like I said, there's just a never-ending supply of die cuts in here. So yeah, they're giving you, if you wanted to make the kits exactly the way they're supposed to, or not they're supposed to, the way that they designed them to go, this is the banana one. So there's like three of the labels to go behind, and there's a couple of little stripes in the blue. This blue is where you're going to stamp Peel Better Soon or one of the other sentiments. So instead of just giving you three of them, they've given you 10 of them. So you got a couple extras. Extras in case you need them, or extras just to make other cool things out of. Look at all the little die cuts. So here's the thing. This is, so this card that has an egg and a piece of toast on it, which is so cute. And then the sample, it says, let's grow mold together. I loaf you. You tell the best yolks. So it's a whole little story dialogue going on with those two. And so you can make three of those cards, but you'll notice there's two of these sheets. So you have extra bananas, extra slices of toast, extra eggs, extra cherries. So lots of extras you can do. So you can redesign the card or just make extra stuff. Little thought bubbles, there's extra ones of those as well. So you get three sheets of these. You need these middle ones to make the cherry card. And then you need three of these thought bubbles for each of the other cards. So yeah, there's an extra thought bubble on each one of these. And then three of these to go on the same on the banana card. So look at all the fun stuff in there. There's die cuts galore and vellum and fun envelopes that could totally be repurposed into other things. Like I said, the cutest punny stamp sets to go with, and I love it when you have stuff that you can stamp on the inside of the cards. I think I may have forgot to mention that before too. As much as Stampin' Up! Makes all these fancy cards, they're generally just white on the inside, right? They're different than the cardstock that they print that is a certain color. These are printed in a different way. So while the outside is very colorful, like the front and back is usually very colorful, the inside is white. So that's nice because then you can stamp on the inside whatever sentiment you want. But you can also stamp any of these little things that go with it. So if you have like, you know, banana card on the outside, you want to stamp a banana in there. Plus you can stamp on the envelopes. Now the envelopes are not always, sometimes the envelopes are too dark to stamp on, but in this case you can. But usually if the envelopes are dark, it's because they have a really cool pattern to them, so you don't really need to stamp. But But yeah, in this case, you could stamp little outside things on there. So we have lots of images. Like I said, there's three different. This guy's frowning, smiling. This is just two smiley faces, just different sizes. Oh, there's a little thing that says hi, too. Glasses, mustache. Said so you can jazz up your fruit and make him look like anybody you want. If you were giving somebody the, you know, a toast to your success with this piece of toast and he happens to have a mustache and glasses, well, you could just make this little piece of toast look like him. I just think it's adorable. So, there you go. That's the kit. I'm going to make some of those cards and find people who need a little laugh in the mail and send out little putty cards to them. So, I hope you enjoy this kit. If you want a refill for it, let me know. The refills have all the goodies in them. Like I said, they just don't have the stamp set or the ink spot. If you're local and, you know, promise to give it back, then I might lend you mine to use them just to make the cards. But, yeah, the only way to guarantee that you're going to get what's in the next kit is to subscribe or to have me order you a kit before the 10th of January deadline. So all I can do for you at this point is the consumables. Sorry. Slight interruption there for my family. Is the consumables. If you want to make sure... What did I do with it? There we go. If you want to make sure that you get the January kit, let me know by the 10th of January that you want it. Or I'll put the link in so you can subscribe if you want to set up your own subscription. If you want to do the prepaid, like wait till the 4th of January when Celebration starts, and do any one of these prepaid subscriptions and get a bunch of Celebration items, let me know. And if you want the add-on, let me know. Lots of fun with Paper Pumpkin. It's a nice little quick pop it together. I mean, most of these you can see from the cards, right? Pull out the envelope you want, pull out the card base you want, pop out a few die cuts, ink up your stamps, stamp up some stuff, assemble it all, and gone. Probably less than an hour to make these 9 cards. So it's a nice, if you need a break from holiday and Christmas, family, weather, these are nice little kits to have. Once a month they come, it's a nice little surprise. It's like Christmas all year. So, I do love Paper Pumpkin, and that's why I'm going to tell you about it each week, because it gives me a lot of joy, gives me a lot of, you know, paper therapy, and who knows, maybe you can do it. And the best part is, whatever you make, you get to send out and, you know, pass on the paper therapy to someone else. So, there we go. I will post the links and stuff here, and I will have everything ready for you to go if you are looking to do stuff in January, whether it's to subscribe, to get me to order you the kit, for Celebration, any of this stuff, just let me know. Final thing that just made me think of that, the 3rd of January, so the day before the new catalog kicks in, and it is loaded with goodies, and Celebration starts, is also the last day for getting most of what's in the Christmas catalog, the holiday catalog, the current little mini. Some of it's on sale, some of it's already sold out, but anything you want in there, the last day to get any of that stuff is the 3rd of January. So if you need help with an order, I am actually putting an order in. I'll probably do it on just after Christmas. You spend some of that Christmas cash. but I do need to order a few things that I want to make sure I get and beat the rush, because on the 4th of January, it's going to be busy, busy, busy with people ordering out of that new catalog because they can, because everybody's trying to get a jump on shipping. So I got a few things I am going to order between now and New Year's. So let me know if there's any last minute stuff you want out of the holiday catalog. And if not, I will just leave you with Paper Pumpkin, an adorable little gnome. And unfortunately, I forgot the name of the lady who posted this and showed how to make it, because he's so adorable. Merry Christmas, everyone. Just going to be hanging with my gnomies. All right. Have a great one, everyone. Thanks very much. Merry Christmas.